But Barack Obama's connection to the Jewish community runs deeper than you might think. Here are some, I got a few little-known Jewish facts about Barack Obama. His name, Barack, comes from the same root as the Hebrew name, Baruch. In Chicago, and this is something that I actually hadn't known, in Chicago, when he was running for the state senate, his campaign was supported by Irving Harris, one of the most influential Jewish businessmen in the city. And Obama, at the time, was actually accused of being too close to the Jewish community. Many of his advisors are Jewish, including his two top campaign advisors, David Axelrod and David Plouffe. Just this past week, the Jerusalem Post reported that a group of retired generals of the Israel Defense Forces and high-ranking Mossad officials have officially endorsed Obama. And something many people don't know, and I've spoken to a lot of people this weekend, is that his wife Michelle's first cousin is a rabbi in Chicago. Has people heard of that, or is that new news? Okay. It was in the forwards. Good. The former congressman of Illinois, Ab Mikva, has gone as far as to say that Barack has a Yiddish neshuma. I hope I pronounced that correctly, but it means a Yiddish soul. The reason so many prominent Jewish leaders support Barack Obama is because he truly embodies the ideals of the Jewish community.
Jerusalem will remain the capital of Israel, and it must remain undivided. There is no room at the negotiating table for terrorist organizations.
Israel has to remain a Jewish state. And what I believe that means is that any negotiated peace between the Israelis and the Palestinians is going to have to involve the Palestinians relinquishing the right of return as it has been understood in the past. A special connection between America and Israel. My starting orientation is A, Israel's security is sacrosanct. It's non-negotiable. That's point number one. Sending message around the world. We will stand with Israel. We want them around, not just for 60 years, but for 600 years. And when I'm president of the United States, they will have an unwavering ally in me. Let me be absolutely clear. Israel is a strong friend of Israel. If Israel was attacked, we would respond forcefully. And an attack on Israel, one of our most important allies in the world, would be considered as an attack on the United States.
The Iranian regime supports violent extremists and challenges us across the region. It pursues a nuclear capability that could spark a dangerous arms race, to raise the prospect of a transfer of nuclear know-how to terrorists. Its president denies the Holocaust and threatens to wipe Israel off the map. The danger from Iran is grave, it is real, and my goal will be to eliminate this threat.
The Palestinians are going to have to recognize that the right of return, as they've understood it historically, would extinguish Israel as a Jewish state, and that's not enough.
Let there be no doubt. I will always keep the threat of military action on the table to defend our security and our ally Israel. Do not be confused.